Good morning.
Good morning
and happy Easter. Thank you. Presiding at today's Mass is Father Mark Ressel. Our opening hymn is Jesus Christ is Risen Today in the Gather, number 556, number 556.
Thank you.
begin the season of resurrection in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
May the grace and the peace of God our Father, who raised Jesus from the dead, be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and let us prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries.
Lord Jesus, risen Son of God, you were anointed by God with the Holy Spirit and power. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, risen Son of God, you are the Paschal Lamb who redeems us. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, risen Son of God, you will come again to judge the living and the dead. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins. Bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. O God, who on this day, through your only begotten Son, have conquered death and unlocked for us the path to eternity, grant, we pray, that we who keep the solemnity of the Lord's resurrection may, through the renewal brought by your Spirit, rise up in the light of life. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Peter proceeded to speak and said, "You know what has happened all over Judea, beginning in Galilee after all baptism
that John preached, how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Spirit and power. He went about doing good and healing all those oppressed by the devil, for God was with him. We are witnesses of all that he did, both in the country of the Jews and in Jerusalem. They put him to death by hanging him on a tree. This man God raised on the third day and granted that he be visible, not to all the people, but to us. The witnesses chosen by God in advance, who ate and drank with him after he rose from the dead. He commissioned us to preach to the people and testify that he is the one appointed by God as judge of the living and the dead. To him all the prophets bear witness that everyone who believes in him will receive forgiveness of sins through his name. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, Do you not know that a little yeast leavens all the dough? Clear out the old yeast, so that you may become a fresh batch of dough, inasmuch as you are unleavened. For our Paschal Lamb, Christ, has been sacrificed. Therefore, let us celebrate the feast, not with the old yeast, the yeast of malice and wickedness, but with the unleavened bread of sincerity and truth. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please remain seated for the singing of the Easter sequence.
Christians, all their voices raise and offer Easter hymns.
with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, Lord.
On the first day of the week, Mary of Magdala came to the tomb early in the morning, while it was still dark, and saw the stone removed from the tomb. So she ran and went to Simon Peter and the other disciple whom Jesus loved and told them, "They have taken the Lord from the tomb, and we don't know where they put him." So Peter and the other disciple went out and came to the tomb. They both ran, but the other disciple ran faster than Peter and arrived at the tomb first. He bent down and saw the burial cloths there, but did not go in. When Simon Peter arrived after him, he went into the tomb and saw the burial cloths there, and the cloth that had covered his head, not with the burial cloth, but rolled up in a separate place. Then the other disciple also went in, the one who had arrived at the tomb first, and he saw and believed. For they did not yet understand the scripture that he had to rise from the dead. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. This gospel, wipe away our sins.
What we do does not make Easter happen. Coloring, hiding, finding eggs may be a lot of fun, not just for the littlest of the children, but that does not make today Easter. Paying homage to a bunny, the writing of sonnets, the wearing of bonnets, may be rites of spring, but they do not make today Easter. Even coming to church does not make this Sunday Easter. What we do does not make Easter happen. Consider then not what we do, but what God does for us in raising Jesus from the dead. It is our faith that resurrection happens, and therefore we must celebrate Easter. We do so not just today with eggs, bunnies, and bonnets. We do so every day that we live our baptismal faith, which proclaims that Christ has died, Christ is risen, Christ will come again. While we can be certain that the tomb was empty when Mary Magdalene and the disciples arrived, today's feast does not proclaim that Jesus Christ was risen once upon a time. No, Jesus Christ is risen today. And therefore, we must gather in prayer, shout Alleluia, and give thanks to the Father who raises Jesus from the dead. It is our Easter faith that resurrection happens. Today, we affirm that the one who was born in a Bethlehem manger, as shepherds and angels joined in song, is raised from the dead. On this morning, we boldly claim that the one who was baptized in the Jordan by John the Baptist and who was transfigured high atop Mount Tabor in the company of Moses and Elijah is raised from the dead. On this greatest solemnity, we announce that the one who walked on water, who turned water into wine, the one who expelled demons, who cured the sick, who healed lepers, who ate with tax collectors, who embraced children, and who welcomed sinners, is raised from the dead. On this holiest day of the year, we proclaim that the one who forgave sins, who preached in parables, who made apostles out of fishermen, and who taught us to call God our Father, is raised from the dead. On this Easter day, in our song, with our words, and through our actions, we witness to our belief that Jesus, who suffered, died, and was buried, is now risen. For the love of God conquers even death itself. Amen, alleluia, it is true. Let everyone know the good news of Easter. Know that this is not a celebration of once upon a time. Notice that for us, resurrection is always in the present tense. Resurrection is how God works. Today on Easter, the holiest of all our days, we proclaim that we, who are the body of Christ, are risen today. It is our faith that resurrection happens. Resurrection happens today when the lonely are remembered, when the hungry are fed, and when the sick are comforted and healed. Resurrection is happening when all that separates, injures, and destroys is overcome by that which unites, heals, and creates. When nonviolent solutions are the means by which we resolve our conflicts. Resurrection happens when the stranger is welcomed, when prejudice is challenged, and when fears are calmed. Resurrection is transforming our selfishness into self-giving, our resentments into forgiveness, our fears into love. Resurrection happens when the fallen are lifted up, when the old are made new, and when all things are brought to perfection by the one who is their creator. For as certainly as spring follows winter, resurrection gives promise to those who mourn and gives hope to those who are tempted to despair. Resurrection happens when, like Mary Magdalene and the disciples, our expectations are challenged, when we are forced to see anew with eyes of faith, when we understand and believe. It is our Easter faith that Christ is risen, that good conquers evil, that truth triumphs over falsehood, that virtue defeats sin, that light overcomes darkness, and that life swallows up death. Easter happens not because of what we do, but because of what God does for us. Therefore, united in prayer today, our parish community of faith, together with the universal church, shouts Alleluia. For Jesus Christ is risen today. We have been buried with Christ in baptism so that we may walk with him in newness of life. So now that our Lenten observance is concluded, let us renew the promises of holy baptism by which we once renounced Satan and his works and promised to serve God in the Holy Catholic Church. And so I ask, do you renounce sin so as to live in the freedom of the children of God?
I do.
Do you renounce the lure of evil so that sin may have no mastery over you?
I do.
Do you renounce Satan, the author and prince of sin?
I do.
Do you believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth?
I do.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, suffered death that was buried, rose again from the dead, and is seated at the right hand of the Father?
I do.
Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting?
I do.
And may Almighty God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has given us new birth by water and the Holy Spirit, and bestowed on us forgiveness of our sins, keep us by his grace in Christ Jesus our Lord for eternal life. Amen. Amen.
I saw water flowing.
This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice in the God who hears and answers our prayers.
Our response is, risen Savior, hear our prayer. For the church, that by our mercy and compassion, that we may raise our brothers and sisters out of the throes of pain and suffering, sharing the good news of the risen Christ, we pray.
Risen Savior, hear our prayer.
For the world, that the peace that Christ brings may extend to every nation, to every community, and to every heart, we pray.
Risen Savior, hear our prayer.
For all who are baptized in Christ yesterday evening, especially Martin Pulse and Daniel Hittner, that they may grow in love of the Lord as they live now as children of the light, we pray.
Risen Savior, hear our prayer.
For all those who could not be with us today, and for those who will bring the Eucharist to them, we pray.
Risen Savior, hear our prayer.
For the parishioners of St. John of the Cross, St. Francis Xavier, and St. Cletus, that we may work together to continue the gospel mission of bringing hope, meaning, and love to our communities, we pray.
Risen Savior, hear our prayer.
For all who are burdened by sickness, disease, or chronic illness, especially those listed in our bulletin, that the risen Christ may bring them light and wholeness, we pray.
Risen Savior, hear our prayer.
For all who have died, especially Anna Friedel, dear friend of Linda Tochi, that they may share the fullness of the resurrection with Christ and all the saints, we pray.
Risen Savior, hear our prayer.
For those we remember at this Mass, Mary Lou O'Gorman, Rachel Schaap, James DeLaurier, Bobby Santucci, Tim Kalman, Young Kenneth Bond, and for those prayers we hold in the silence of our hearts, we pray.
Risen Savior, hear our prayer. O God, who announced good news through the mystery of the empty tomb, fill the longing of our hearts and grant these prayers through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Thank you.
pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Amen. Exultant with paschal gladness, O Lord, we offer the sacrifice by which your church is wonderfully reborn and nourished through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. And let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right.
Truly right and just, our duty and our salvation at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but on this day above all to laud you yet more gloriously when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For he is the true Lamb who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying, he has destroyed our death, and by rising, restored our life. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise. And even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. To you, therefore, most merciful Father, we make humble prayer and petition through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, that you accept and bless these gifts, these offerings, these holy and unblemished sacrifices, which we offer you firstly for your holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant her peace, to guard, unite, and govern her throughout the whole world, together with your servant, Francis, our Pope, and Blaise, our Bishop, and all those who, holding to the truth, hand on the Catholic and Apostolic faith. Remember, Lord, your servants, and all gathered here whose faith and devotion are known to you. For them we offer you this sacrifice of praise, or they offer it for themselves and for all those who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls, in hope of health and well-being, and paying their homage to you, the eternal God, living and true. Celebrating the most sacred day of the resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ in the flesh, and in communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious ever-Virgin Mary, mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, and blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon, and Jude, Linus, Cletus, Clement, Sixtus, Cornelius, Cyprian, Lawrence and Chrysogenus, John and Paul, Cosmos and Damian, and all of your saints. We ask that through their merits and prayers, in all things we may be defended by your protecting help. Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family, which we make to you also for those to whom you have been pleased to give new birth of water and the Holy Spirit, granting them forgiveness of all their sins. Order our days in your peace. And command that we be delivered from eternal damnation and counted among the flock of those you have chosen. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven, to you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when the supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands. And once more, giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the Blessed Passion, the resurrection from the dead, and the glorious ascension into heaven of Christ, your Son, our Lord, we, your servants and your holy people, offer to your glorious majesty from the gifts you've given to us this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance and to accept them as once you were pleased to accept the gifts of your servant Abel, the just, the sacrifice of Abraham, our father in faith, and the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer, we ask you, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us who through this participation of the altar receive the most holy body and blood of your Son may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing. Remember also, Lord, your servants who have gone before us with the sign of faith and who rest in the sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace. To us also, your servants, who though sinners, hope in your abundant mercies, graciously grant some share in fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Marcellinus, Peter, Felicity, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, and all of your saints, admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon through Christ our Lord, through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord. You sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit. All glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin, safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus the Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. Graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit. Let us offer each other a sign of Christ's peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. But I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof. Only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. May the body and the blood of Christ keep us safe for eternal life.
Our communion hymn is Take and Eat in the Gather, number 1009, number 1009.
Thank you.
do. Amen. The body of Christ. The body of Christ.
Let us pray. Look upon your church, O God, with unfailing love and favor, so that, renewed by the Paschal mysteries, she may come to the glory of the resurrection through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Just a word of thanks to the many who have made our Lenten Triduum and now Easter celebrations prayerful and beautiful. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit. Bow down for the blessing.
May Almighty God bless you through today's Easter solemnity, and in his compassion, defend you from every assault of sin.
Amen.
And may he who restores you to eternal life in the resurrection of his only begotten endow you with the prize of immortality.
Amen.
Now that the days of the Lord's Passion have drawn to a close, may you who celebrate the gladness of the Paschal Feast come with Christ's help and exulting in spirit to those feasts that are celebrated in eternal joy.
Amen.
And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down on you and remain with you forever.
Amen. Go forth, the Mass is ended. Alleluia. Alleluia.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia. Alleluia.
Our recessional hymn is Sing with All the Saints in Glory, in the hymnal number 563, number 563.